Good evening. Tonight is our senior game where we recognize our 12th grade student athletes and their families who participate in varsity cheerleading and play varsity football. Our first student athlete we would like to honor is Abby Galida, who is participating in her first year of fall varsity cheer. Abby has been competing in competitive dance for the past 13 years. She is joined by family members Chris and Nicole, and she plans on studying pre-law in the future. Next, we have Emily Carr, who is participating in her fourth year of varsity cheer. Emily has been competing in cheer for 11 years. She is joined by Debbie Wheeler, Deborah McTighe, and Jonna Preciado. In the future, she plans to study education and hopes to become a high school teacher. Now on to our varsity football seniors. Our first senior has been participating in varsity football for 2 years. I'd like to honor Jackson Roach, accompanied by family members Stephen, Annie, and Aiden. Jackson's plans for the future include studying farming and business in college. Our next senior has been participating in varsity football for 2 years. I'd like to honor Dan Tomaselli, accompanied by Coach Liam. Dan's plans for the future include studying marketing and business in college. Now I'd like to honor Ryan Basler, who's been participating in varsity football for 3 years. He's accompanied by family members Bernie and Mark. Ryan's plans for the future include studying his passion for welding. Our next senior has been participating in varsity football for 3 years. I'd like to honor Jason Gauté, accompanied by his family members Tracy and Mark. Jason plans to join the workforce after high school. Our next senior has been participating in varsity football for 3 years. I'd like to honor Colin Fuller. He's accompanied by family members Christine and Brian. Colin plans on playing college football and studying strength and conditioning. Our next senior has been participating in varsity football for all 4 years of high school. I'd like to honor Phil Struther. He is accompanied by his family members Yvette and Jerome. Phil plans on studying business in college. Our next senior has been participating in all 4 years of high school football. That is Tyson DiStefano. He's accompanied by family members Tracy and JD. Tyson's plans for the future include following his passion for welding. Our next senior has also been playing varsity football for 4 years. I'd like to honor Evan O'Connor. He's accompanied by family members Allison and Peter. In the future, Evan plans on studying business in college. And last and certainly not least, our last senior has been playing varsity football for all 4 years of high school. I'd like to honor Declan Noonan. He's accompanied by family members Alicia and Sean. Declan plans on joining the law enforcement after high school. Let's have a nice round of applause for all our senior athletes and their family members. All right, picture time, everybody. Can you guys get together? Can we get one more big hand for all our senior athletes and their family members? Thank you, everyone, for the years you put in to this program. While I have your attention, we need one more person to do the chain gang. We have Mr. Barkley and Ms. Marston. We need one more person to volunteer. Please go down to the gate by the track if you're willing to do the chain gang. We need one more volunteer. Thank you. We do need one more volunteer for the chain gang. Can we get one more volunteer? Please go down to the gate. The gate by the track. We need one volunteer. Thank you.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming? And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Way to go, Maddie Granger. Justin Hansey set to kick off for the Dragons. Antonio Lopez carries it for the Spartans out past the 25. That's where they're going to take over first and 10. Dan Tomaselli, senior, with the tackle on the play. Anthony Hoyt keeps himself for the Spartans, brings it out to the midfield. Joe Kennedy with the tackle for the Dragons. Going to be first and 10 for Spackenkill. Hunter Gent with the carry. Tackled again by Joe Kennedy. Picks up 8 on the play. Going to be second down and 2. Hoyt's pass is complete to number 87, Dominic Frazier. Push out of bounds by number 3, Evan O'Connor. But not after the Spartans pick up a first down. Hoyt's pass to Lopez is good for a Spartan touchdown. Two-point try is no good, but the Spartans do get on the board first with a 6-0 lead over the Dragons. Ryan Hoyt set the kickoff for the Spartans. We have Evan O'Connor and Joe Kennedy back deep for the Dragons. Kennedy brings it out to the 40-yard line, but there is a flag on the play. Antonio Lopez was on a tackle for the Spartans. Holding goes against the Dragons. Going to be a 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Dragons are going to take over first and 10. DiStefano scrambles, gains 9 yards on the play. Going to be second down and 1. DiStefano's pass is complete to Declan Noonan, tackled by Steven Ciancino. But the Dover Dragons pick up a first down. Hand off to Colin Fuller, senior. pulled down by Kevin Mullins, but not after the Dover Dragons pick up a first down. Pitch goes to Fuller, gets back to the line of scrimmage, brought down by Cole Dominic of the Spartans. Second down and 10. DeStefano's pass intended for Joe Kennedy goes incomplete. Dominic Frazier in on a coverage. Going to be third down and 10 for the Dragons. DeStefano's pass is complete to Evan O'Connor across the middle. Kevin Mullins with the tackle for the Spartans. Going to be fourth down and 3. DeStefano keeps himself and picks up the first down and more. Brings it down to the 5-yard line where the Dragons are going to take over first and goal. DeStefano's pass is complete to Declan Noonan for a gain of 3 yards. Second and goal from the 2. Hand off to Colin Fuller, and it is a touchdown for the Dover Dragons. DeStefano keeps himself and is good for the 2-point conversion. Senior Colin Fuller with the touchdown and DeStefano with the 2-point conversion. Dragons take an 8-6 lead. He set the kickoff for the Dragons. Cincio pitches it back to Antonio Lopez, who brings it out to about the 39-yard line. Spartans will have the ball there, first and 10. Handoff goes to Daniel Collins, pulled down by Joe Kennedy for the Dragons, but not after Collins picks up a first down. It'll be first and 10 from the Dover 35-yard line. Handoff to Collins again, tackled by Hansey for the Dragons. Picks up 6 on the play. Second down and 4. Quarterback Anthony Hoyts keeps himself, pulled down by Colin Fuller for the Dragons, but not after Spartans pick up a first down. It's going to be first and 10 from the Dover 15-yard line. False start by the Spartans, going to back him up 5 yards. First and 15 from the Dover 20-yard line. Anthony Hoyt's pass goes incomplete, tipped by number 2, Justin Hansey for the Dragons. Going to be second down and 15 yards to go. We have another false start on Spackenkill. Going to back him up another 5 yards. It's going to be second down and 20 yards to go. Hoyt's pass goes complete to Daniel Collins. It's a Spackenkill Spartan touchdown. Two-point try is good with Hoyt's pass going to number 18, Cole Dominic. Spackenkill takes a 14-8 lead. Brian Hoyt set the kickoff for the Spartans. Evan O'Connor and Joe Kennedy back deep for the Dragons. O'Connor with the return out to their own 40-yard line. Dragons are going to be first and 10. DeStefano sacked in the backfield by Jacob Gordon for the Spartans. Loss of one on a play. Going to be second down and 11. Noonan pulled down for a loss of one. Going to be third down and 12. Penalty against the Dragons is declined. Going to be third down and 12 for the Dragons. DeStefano's pass intended for number 3, senior Evan O'Connor. Broken up by Antonio Lopez for Spackenkill. Going to be fourth and long for the Dragons. Colin Fuller's punt goes to number 87, Dominic Frazier, who brings it back to midfield and is pushed out of bounds. Spackenkill will take over first and 10 from about midfield. Justin Hansey with the sack for the Dover Dragons and a loss of 7 yards. Going to be second and long for Spackenkill. Hoyt keeps himself, gets back to the original line of scrimmage. Tackled by number 9, Tyler Cargain. Hoyt's pass is complete to Kevin Mullins, tackled by Jason Gote. But not after the Spartans pick up a first down. Going to be first and 10 from the Dover 25-yard line. Hunter Gent carries it. Declan Noonan with the tackle for the Dragons. Second and 9. Anthony Hoyt keeps himself, tackled by Joe Kennedy, but gains 3 on the play. Going to be third down. And that's the end of the first quarter. At the end of the first quarter, the Dragons are trailing 8-14. Now, if you could please draw your attention to the track where our cheerleaders have a nice little presentation for us at the end of the first quarter. To start the second quarter, Spackenkill is going to have the ball. Third down and 5 from the Dover 20-yard line. Hoyt keeps himself to the left side, pushed out of bounds by Jason Gauthe. Spackenkill picks up a first down on the play. Going to be first and goal from the Dover 4-yard line. Two-point conversion is good. Hand off to Hunter Gent. No, that was a touchdown. Oh, excuse me. It's a touchdown. Touchdown by Hunter Gent. They will now be going for the two-point conversion. No good. Two-point conversion is no good. Spartans do have a 20-8 lead. Brian Hoyt set to kick off for the Spartans. Joe Kenny and Evan O'Connor back deep for the Dragons. O'Connor picks up the kick and brings it out to the 42-yard line. That's where the Dragons are going to take over first and 10. DeStefano keeps himself and picks up 6 yards. Cole Dominick with the tackle for the Spartans. Hand off to Jason Vitolo, ends up just short of the first down. It's going to be third and inches. DeStefano keeps it himself. And the ball is ripped from his arms. Spackenkill will take over first down from the Dover 45-yard line. Hoyt's pass goes incomplete, intended for Dan Collins. Justin Hansey in on the coverage. Second down and 10 for Spackenkill. Hoyt keeps himself run down by number 11, Joe Kennedy, but not after the Spartans pick up a first down. There is a flag on the play. Play is going to be coming back. Holding by Spackenkill. Going to be a 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. That brings it back to the 39-yard line of Spackenkill. Officials seem to be figuring out where the ball should be spotted. Going to be second down and 13 to go. False start by Spackenkill is going to back him up 5 more yards. Second down and a long 17 to go. Hoyt's pass is complete to Steven Ciancio. Picks up a Spackenkill first down. Tackled by Joe Kennedy for the Dragons. First and 10 from the Dover 33-yard line. Dan Collins gets the handoff, taken down by number 22, senior Declan Noonan. Picks up 3 on the play, going to be second down and 7 to go. Collins carries it again, picks up a first down, then gets tackled by number two, Justin Hansey. Hoyt keeps himself, pulled down by number 75, Robert Leary. Going to be second down and 8 to go from the Dover 15-yard line. Hoyt's pass is good to Dominic Frazier for a Spartan touchdown. Hoyt's pass to Cole Dominic is no good for the two-point conversion. Spartans do have a 26-8 lead, though. And I just got word that there's pizza in the snack shack. So if you're looking to get a bite to eat, now would be a good time to get it. I'm sure all 80 people watching at home on the live stream are jealous that they cannot get the pizza from Gertie Snack Shack to support our senior class. Brian Hoyt set the kickoff for the Spartans. Joe Kennedy and Evan O'Connor back to receive for the Dragons. Evan O'Connor with the big return down to the Spartan kill 30-yard line. Eventually pulled down by Alan Stevanu. Dragons are going to take over first and 10. DeStefano keeps himself, runs to the left side, and is eventually pushed out of bounds, but not after he picks up 8 big yards. Going to be second down and 2. Pass to the right side to Evan O'Connor is completed. tackled by Cole Dominic, but not after the Dover Dragons pick up a first down. DeStefano's pass is good to number 22, senior Declan Noonan, and that is a Dover Dragons touchdown. Tyson with the two-point conversion is good. Dragons trail 16-26. Hansi set the kick for the Dragons. Onside kick try is unsuccessful for the Dragon. Jumped on by Cole Dominic for the Spartans. They're going to take over first and 10 from the Dover 46-yard line. Hand off to Hunter Gent, picks up 9 on the play. Ultimately tackled by Justin Hansey for the Dragons. Going to be 2nd down and 1. Hoyt's pass goes to Antonio Lopez. No gain on the play as he was pulled down by Justin Hansey for the Dragons. We're going to have 3rd down and 2 now. Hunter Gent carries it. Tackle close to the 1st down marker. And that is a Spartan 1st down. It's going to be 1st and 10 from the Dragon 35-yard line. Hoyt carries the ball and is tackled just short of the goal line. by Justin Hansey. It's going to be first and goal for the Spartans. Handoff to Gent is good for a back and kill touchdown. Timeout by Spackenkill. Timeout was called before the delay of game penalty. Hoyt's pass is incomplete. Two-point try is no good. But the Spartans lead the Dragons 32-16. Brian Hoyt set to kick off for the Spartans. Joe Kennedy and Evan O'Connor back deep for the Dragons. O'Connor runs it past midfield, eventually pulled down by Alan Stavagno. DiStefano keeps himself, gains 8 on the play, pulled down by Carter Usher. Handoff to Evan O'Connor is good for a Dover Dragon. First down. DiStefano keeps himself, pulled down by Cole Dominic. Gain of 7 on the play. Going to be 2nd down and 3 to go. DiStefano's pass intended for Evan O'Connor goes incomplete. We're going to have 3rd down and 3. DiStefano keeps himself and picks up a Dover Dragon. First down. DiStefano's pass intended for Joe Kennedy goes incomplete. Ciancio on the coverage. Hand off to Otolo is good for a Dover Dragon touchdown. Is a flag on the play, though. Dover Dragon touchdown is going to be coming back, holding on the play. Going to be a 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Remain 2nd down. DiStefano keeps himself, pulled down by number 55, Alan Stevano. Going to be 3rd and long for the Dragons, a minute to go in the half. DiStefano picks up 7 on the play. Going to be 4th down and 13 yards to go. Hand off to left side for Vitolo. Going to be close to a 1st down. And it is just short. Turnover on down. Spackenkill is going to take over. Forty-one seconds left to go in the half. Hand off to Dan Collins. Gains two on the play. Second down. And that's going to do it for the half. Spackenkill leads 32-16 over the Dover Dragons.
What does the team have to do in the second half?
Play a part. Take the momentum.
Yeah, do you want... Can you say hello? Say hello. We're just testing the mic.
Yeah. Mic check, mic check.
Do you guys have ball boys for the second half? You do, or? Yes.
Check, check.
What does the team have to do in the second half?
Play with heart, chasing the momentum. We're getting the ball back in the second half. We need to put some points on the board. Our running game, we need to, our line needs to open up. To have a pathway for Tyson, Jason, and for Colin to get more yards defensively.
That should be good.
Okay.
Dover Dragons are going to receive the second half ball. Joe Kennedy back deep for the Dragons. Brian Hoyt set the kick for the Spartans. Kick goes out of bounds, illegal procedure. A legal procedure against the Spartans for kicking it out of bounds. Dover's going to take over from their 36-yard line. Carried by number 20, Jason Vitolo. Tackled by Jacob Gordon. Going to be 2nd and 7. DeStefano's pass intended for Joe Kennedy goes incomplete. Broken up by Antonio Lopez. Going to be 3rd down and 7 to go. Oh, but there is a flag on the play. Personal foul penalty against Backenkill. We're going to have to check the spot of this penalty. That's going to move the ball up to the Spackenkill 45-yard line where the Dragons are going to take over. 1st down. DeStefano keeps himself at scrambles for 2 yards. It's going to be 2nd down and 8. Kevin Mullins with the tackle for the Spartans. DeStefano keeps himself, picks up 2 yards on the play, but there is a flag. Going to be holding against the Dragons. Ball is going to be placed back to the Dragon 45-yard line. Remain 2nd down. DeStefano gains 2 on the play. Going to be 3rd and long. DeStefano's pass to Joe Kennedy is incomplete. Going to be fourth down and long. On fourth down, DeStefano's pass is incomplete, intended to for Declan Noonan. Kevin Mullins in on the coverage. Spackenkill's going to take over first and 10 from about midfield. Hunter Gent with the carry and the first down. Chased down by Justin Hansey of the Dragons. But not after he picks up about 50 yards on the play, and it's going to be first and goal from the Dragon 9-yard line. Hoyt's pass is no good, and a two-point try is incomplete. Oh, excuse me. It's going to be second down. Hand off to Hunter Gent. Gains about 5 yards on the play. It's going to be third down and goal. Ball is spotted at the 2-yard line. Hoyt zigzags his way into the end zone for a Spackenkill touchdown. Dan Collins keeps himself for a successful 2-point try. Spackenkill takes a 40-16 lead. Brian Hoyt getting ready to kick for the Spack and Kill Spartans. Joe Kennedy, you never know, Connor back for the Dover Dragons. Flag on the play, illegal procedure as the kick goes out of bounds. Penalty is going to let the Dragons take over from the Spack and Kill 48-yard line. First and 10. Hand off to Evan O'Connor. Gains 11 yards on the play, and that is a Dover Dragon first down. DeStefano keeps it, runs to the right side, picks up 5 yards on the play. Going to be second down and 5 from the 33-yard line. DeStefano's pass intended for Joe Kennedy goes incomplete. Steven Ciancio in on the coverage. Going to be third down and 7 to go. Hand off to Jason Vitolo, picks up 3 yards on the play. It's going to be fourth down for the Dragons. DeStefano sacked in the backfield by Hunter Gent. And that's going to be a turnover on downs by the Dragons. Spack and Kill will take over near midfield. It's going to be first and 10 from the Spack and Kill 45-yard line. Hand off to Ciancio. Pushed out of bounds by Colin Fuller. Picks up 9 yards on the play. It's going to be second and 1. Hoyt keeps it himself. Gets close to the first down marker, but just shy. Taken down by Evan O'Connor for the Dragons. Third and inches. Hand off to Dan Collins. Gains a little bit on the play. Not sure if it's enough for the first down. Tackled by Justin Hansey. And it is a Spack and Kill first down. First and 10 from the Dover 45-yard line. Hoyt's pass is good to Kevin Mullins. Jason Gauthe on the coverage to tackle him. But not after the Spack and Kill Spartans pick up a first down. Going to be first and 10 from the Dover 24-yard line. Declan Noonan pulls down number 44, Dan Collins, going to be second and 8. Fumble on the exchange. But recovered by Alan Stavanio. Lost a couple yards on the play. It's going to be third down and 11. Hoyt's pass is complete to Ciancio. Evan O'Connor with the tackle. Just shy of the first down, so it's going to be fourth and inches. Let's get loud. Let those Dragon boys hear you. Dan Collins runs it up the gut and gets the first down for the Spartans. It's going to be first and 10 from the 10-yard line, about the 11. Hoyt keeps himself. Knocked down by Joe Kennedy. Going to be second down from the Dover 4-yard line. pre-snap penalty. And it's against back and kill. False start. Going to back him up 5 yards. Going to be second down and 6. Hoyt keeps himself and gets back to the line of scrimmage. Going to be 3rd down and 7 to go. Passes intended for Ciancio is incomplete. It's going to be 4th down, but that is the end of the 3rd quarter. Dragons trailing the Spartans 16-40. To start the 4th quarter, it's going to be 4th down and 9 to go. Dragons need to stop. Let them hear you, Dragon fans. All right, get loud. Pass is broken up by Evan O'Connor, and the Dragons are going to take over on downs. First and 10 for the Dragons from their own 9-yard line. DeStefano keeps it himself, runs it to the left side, and picks up a Dover Dragon. First down! DeStefano's pass intended for O'Connor goes incomplete. Collins in on the coverage. Going to be second down and 10. DeStefano's pass to O'Connor is complete. Eleven-yard gain, and that is a Dover Dragon first down. Flag on the play. We have a face mask penalty against the Spartans, and that's going to get a Dover Dragon first down. Hand off to Joe Kennedy, runs to the outside and picks up 5 yards on the play. Gets to about midfield, it's going to be second and 5. DeStefano keeps himself. Push out of bounds by Dominic Frazier, but not after he picks up a Dover Dragon. First down! DeStefano's pass is good to Joe Kennedy. Pushed out of bounds by Ciancio, but he picks up 30 yards on the play. Pass intended for O'Connor is incomplete. Lopez on the coverage, going to be second down and 10 from the Spackenkill 16-yard line. Pitch to the left side to Vitolo. Gains 4 yards on the play, but we have some flags. We have a block in the back by Dover. Going to back him up from the spot of the foul. DeStefano gained some of those yards back with the carry. Pulled down by Dan Collins. Going to be third and long for the Dragons. Just a reminder, look for the girls, the cheerleaders, selling 50-50 raffle tickets in the stands. The pot's up to over $100, I hear. Pass intended for Evan O'Connor is incomplete, broken up by Cole Dominic for the Spartans. Going to be fourth and long for the Dragons. Last chance to buy those 50-50 raffle tickets. And we have a touchdown caught by Evan O'Connor of the Dragons. Yard bomb, but there is a flag on the play. Let's check what the foul is. Pass interference by the defense. Oh. Penalties declined, and that is a Dover Dragon touchdown. DiStefano keeps himself and is good for the two-point try. Dragons cut into the lead, now trailing 24-40. Okay, that pass interference penalty is going to be assessed on a kickoff. Dragons are going to be kicking off from the Spack and Kill 45-yard line. Hansey set to kick. And kicker Justin Hansey recovers it himself, running all the way down the field. And he falls on it. at the Smack and Kill 8-yard line. That's where the Dragons are going to take over. First and goal. DeStefano gains 1 yard on the play. Going to be second down and goal. DeStefano gains 1 more yard. Going to be third and goal. DeStefano gets sacked, but we have 2 flags on the play. Last chance to get your 50-50 raffle tickets. If you would like to buy one, go down to the cheerleaders. They'll be happy to sell you one. The pot is well over $100 this week. Personal foul, face mask against Back and Kill. Moves the ball up to the 7-yard line, but it will be third down. DeStefano keeps himself and gains 5 yards on a play, brings it down to the 2-yard line. It's going to be fourth down and goal. Need a touchdown here. Let those boys hear you. Stop your feet. Hold up. Timeout by Spack and Kill. Fourth and goal. Let's get loud. Tyson does not get into the end zone. Turnover on downs. Spadenkill is going to take over first and 10 from their own 1-yard line. Hand off to Hunter Gent. Doesn't get very far. Pulled down by Justin Hansey. Going to be second down. And I just got word that some new pizza just arrived in a Snack Shack. So if anyone's still hungry or did not have a chance to get a slice, feel free to head over to the Snack Shack and get a slice of pizza. Sorry to those 150 fans watching at home. You cannot have some of our local pizza. Gent with the carry again, pulled down by senior Jason Gauthier. But not before the Spartans pick up a first down. Hunter Gent with the carry, picks up a first down, tackled by Jason Gauthier. Let's give a nice hand for our Dover senior, Evan O'Connor. First and 10 from the Spackenkill 43-yard line. Hunter Gent went to carry, tackled by Dan Duncan for the Dragons. Get those 50-50 raffle tickets ready. I hear we have a winning number. So you might want to take them out. We'll be calling out that number soon. Pot got up to $127. It's going to be second down and 3 from midfield. Carried by Gent again, tackled by number 69, senior Ryan Baszler. Gent gets the first down and more. Eventually pulled down by number 15, senior Jason Gauthier. Again, have those 50-50 raffle tickets in hand. We'll be calling that number very, very shortly. Timeout, Dover. All right. So the 50-50 raffle got up to $127 for the winner. Have those tickets out as we're going to call out the winning number. Here we go. Winning raffle ticket is 608-347. 608-347. If you have the winning raffle ticket, please come down to the cheerleaders to collect your winnings. 608-347. Do we have a winner, Miss Davis Bogan? No? Might have to pull another number. Collins with the carry. Tackled by Sean Barkley. Dan Collins with the carry, tackled by Jason Gauthier. And I found out the cheerleaders pulled another number because we did not have anyone claim the number for the first winning. So hopefully you hung on to those tickets. As we have another number pulled, we'll be calling out that number shortly, the new number. Gent tackled in the backfield. First one there was number 69, Ryan Baszler. And we have a timeout by the Dragons. All right, so take those 50-50 raffle tickets out, and here is the new number. And the new number is 608-249. 608-249. Check your tickets. Please go down to the track. Hoyt's throw is good to Dominic Frazier for a Spack and Kill Spartan touchdown. Timeout, Spack and Kill. So the winner was Mrs. Nelson, who decided to donate the money back to the cheerleaders. Thank you, Mrs. Nelson, for your generosity. We appreciate it. Two-point try is no good, but Spackenkill does extend the lead to 46-24. Hoyt set to kick off for the Spartans. O'Connor and Hansey back deep for the Dragons. Kick goes out of bounds. Flag on the play. Time from their own 40-yard line. Kick is picked up by Justin Hansey. Runs it out to the Dover 25-yard line. That's where they're going to take over. First and 10. 96 seconds left in the game. He's the final tackled by 17, Kevin Mullins. DeStefano's pass is intended for Justin Hansey, goes incomplete. We are streaming this game online. I just got word we broke our own record. 153 fans are watching at home. The exchange is fumbled, picked up by number 55, Alan Stavanananu. Hoyt takes a knee. Second down. This is our senior night, and I would like to recognize one last time before the game's over our seniors, Jackson Roach, Dan Tomaselli, Ryan Baszler, Jason Gote, Colin Fuller, Phil Struther, Tyson DiStefano, Evan O'Connor, Declan Noonan. Thank you for all the years you put into this program to our seniors. And that knee by Hoyt is going to end the game. Spack and Kill wins 46-24.